Hey team, this is Velasquez, and we are ready to officially kick off week number 6, and we're wrapping up Unit 1, which is our title this week, which is the Unit 1 exam. So quick reminder before we jump in, just at the top of the week 6 tab, you're going to find just a quick reminder, progress reports. Yes, it's true. Progress reports, are due. For our purposes, I'll be closing the gradebook at 4 o'clock on Thursday. So progress reports must be submitted by Friday morning. That will get me a few short hours to go ahead and tidy up, hopefully some missing assignments. Please be proactive with your missing assignments. If you have been submitting late work, there are quite a few assignments that are trickling in. I appreciate those people that are taking the time to send me an email. So a proper etiquette, of course, would just make sure you're putting your name, your student ID number, and then also if you could specifically list the assignments that you have been submitted so that I can make sure they're accurate in the gradebook. So for example, someone yesterday sent me an email that said basically, Ms. Sanchez, will you please check my democracy one pager? And I resubmitted my end of the week reflection. So that way I know I specifically know I need to address those missing assignments. All right, please know I have already started making some calls home. I made some great calls home. We have some really strong scores, but we do have a few people that are slipping a bit in regards to making sure the assignments are submitted on time. Okay, so I can be flexible. Obviously, again, this is flexible learning, but we want to keep in mind if you do have more than two or three zeros in the gradebook, you definitely want to contact me and you want to make sure you were catching up because progress reports are due this week, folks. And then believe it or not, we are looking ahead to October 4th. And that will mean we'll be wrapping up for first quarter. All right, so just kind of general overview. Finally, I also want to give a shout out before we get started to those members of the team who attend Saturday Academy. Remember, Saturday Academy is just another time, a block of time that you can use to either use Chromebooks, address any questions that you may have regarding the course. So for those people that attended on Saturday, they were able to use their time wisely and catch up with a few assignments. Marking your calendars early, I will be hosting another Saturday Academy, which is September 21st. So I'll go ahead and put that on the reminders for you guys as well. All right, so let's go ahead and dive into it. So you can see week 6, I've opened up 6 assignments. Okay, so if you scroll down to the bottom of week 6, you're going to find 6 folders. Okay, the first one, of course, nothing new here. You're going to find your weekly calendars. I did post a little grit video, a little bit of determination since we're halfway through, getting closer to the quarter. Also, again, posted again your different assignments for week 6. Week 6 reflections, please keep in mind 2 to 3 sentences. If you're just putting good, that's not enough to get you your points for the reflection. I'm also noticing a lot of people are honestly reflecting and talking about what they didn't do for the day. So some people are writing, well, to be honest, I never logged into Schoology. I didn't think about the history work for today because I had an English essay due, which I appreciate your honesty, of course. But I do want to remind you, of course, and stress, if you're finding in your reflections you're not able to carve out some time within the week to address your course, you might want to sit down with that agenda and think about how you can sort of restructure your time. Okay, so there's definitely time of day. Assignments are laid out ahead of schedule, so you can kind of plan ahead. But you definitely do not want to wait to the last minute on these assignments. And you also want to think about where you can carve a quiet space. I'm also finding some people in the end of the week reflections are talking a little bit about, of course, why it's difficult to make time for the course, finding a quiet space or finding internet access. So definitely you want to think about resources, whether it's your school library, your public library. Of course, you're on Anaheim campus. My classroom 106 is always open for you as well. Okay, so thank you for your honest reflections and definitely keep them coming. Reminder, that's an expectation for the course is that you are logging in at least once a day with a quick check-in. And then also, of course, the end of the week reflection. Okay, 6.2 is going to be a review activity for our Flipgrid. I am super excited for the documentary, or I should say the PSAs I've already taken a look at. So I feel like you guys really got into the creativity of what it means to promote civic education and why democracy matters. So I'm really really excited to see the rest of the team's posts. I am going to ask that for sure tonight you post your Flipgrid, because tomorrow during the team conference, we're going to go ahead and view some of the Flipgrid posts. You can see that I posted a Flipgrid democracy PSA guide. This is going to ask you to at least watch 5 of your teammates' videos. Now, I put just some kind of guiding prompts. So the focus, so a few people, they focus specifically on maybe one democratic ideal like due process. A few people went in a little bit more background history, for example, the Greek contributions. So what was the focus of the PSA? Were there any taglines, maybe a golden line from the presentation or PSA? And then I also use a little strategy when we do peer evaluations. It's called TAG feedback. TAG feedback usually is an acronym to remember. Tell something you liked. So what went well? Ask a thoughtful question about what they've posted, or maybe again, how they promoted democracy and civic engagement. And then give a positive suggestion on what thing perhaps they should have added, or maybe for next time they should consider. All right, so this, there is also a Dropbox posted into the team conference for week six. All right, and next assignment on the list, getting you closer to our test this week. I've also posted a 6.3, which is a Unit 1 study guide discussion board. Now, the discussion board is a series of stems, so I can statements. So before you click on the Unit 1 exam, you should be able to state these. So I can explain what a republic is. It started in Rome. It is a representative system, right? You should sort of mentally go through that checklist. I'm asking just to make sure that help the team review. I did post a discussion. Okay, the Unit 1 discussion is structured very similar to a tutorial format in which you're going to ask a question relating to the study guides. You want to sort of brainstorm what you already know about the topic. Again, list any academic vocab or definitions, which we've definitely worked through lectures, reading articles, and our vocab tables. And then the last is write briefly what you know about the topic. Okay, so in an ideal world, you're picking something that you truly need to review. So try not to just repost a question, you know, why does democracy matter? Okay, because I feel like for most of the team, you guys got a solid understanding. Is there something that you're a little fuzzy on? Perhaps maybe something on the Greek philosophers or something along the lines of the difference between a direct and indirect democracy, because those are also very much on the exam this week. Okay, so I'm looking for one post and I'm looking for you guys to respond or maybe add on to someone's knowledge in regards to the discussion feedback. All right, as we continue on for the week, we are, of course, this week will be the anniversary of events known as September 11th. So for this process, we're actually going to kind of flash back to our historical inquiry process. Okay, so for historical inquiry, remember we looked at a series of different lenses we can look at or different questions. Okay, so for example, cause and effect, change in continuity, turning points, which you can definitely argue September 11th was a turning point in our own U.S. history as well as the world history. Okay, using the past and through their eyes. All right, so for this piece, you're going to have to do a little bit of historical inquiry as well as create an interview. Okay, so I'm asking you to go ahead and there's a video clip, okay, or a video that kind of gives you some background. I know most of you youngsters were not born, of course, during the events or tragic events of September 11th. Okay, so for those of you that kind of know obviously what it refers to, is it just a video to kind of just connect with some ideas, some stories, and some images? Okay, once you've watched the video, then I'm going to ask you to click here for the actual template. Okay, and the template in essence is you're going to conduct an interview. Now you can read for yourself, but of course at the bottom it gives you the directions. Okay, what you're going to do, I really want to highlight right here that the person you interview must have at least been in middle school or older during 9/11. Okay, so we're looking for someone that has this pretty strong recollection and can tell you a story. Now, I find it hard to believe that most adults, if you ask them again, do you remember where you were on the morning of September 11th? Most adults, including myself, have a story. It's very vivid for a lot of us who lived through the time period. Okay, So for example, on September 11th, I remember I woke up that morning and I was getting ready to go to Cal State Fullerton. And I remember turning on the news and having my coffee and thinking, gee, I don't even know what to do because I was so in shock. And I didn't know if I should go to Cal State Fullerton. And I can remember huddled around the student union, kind of watching the TV in shock. So lots of details come to mind. And I'm sure the adult that you choose is going to have, you know, a very vivid account. Okay. So whether you choose to do your mom, your relative, maybe a teacher on your campus, after you conduct the interview, you get to pick. Okay. You get to choose a written response. So the written response to the writing task, number one, you can choose to do an informative piece. So basically write an objective summary of the interview, okay, putting the facts together. Number two, you can choose to create a narrative piece. I know some of you are in the arts and creative and kind of want to, you know, cast yourself as the person or kind of create that narrative scene. And then the last piece that you can choose to write about is research. So if you're curious about this topic and when you conduct additional research to learn something about that your interviewee kind of mentioned within the interview. Okay, so the directions are spelled out, but that's kind of the basic premise. Okay, so it gives you some places. It gives you also some questions. Okay, besides the historical inquiry questions, okay, kind of just ideas of how to approach your interview subject. And then I just gave you some space in right here to, again, you're choosing your writing task in a safe space below. Okay, I gave you rubric in the bottom as well as some reflections. So my hope for this piece, not only is it going to obviously help connect to this week in honor of the September 11th, but it's also getting you to kind of practice the skills of what it means to be a historian and kind of conduct that piece as well as work on your writing. Okay. Finally, as we wrap up the week, I have also opened up, or I will be opening up, excuse me, the Unit 1 multiple choice. Unit 1 multiple choice will be 30 questions, multiple choice. Please know, again, it is timed. Okay. And it's not something you can open and necessarily come back to the day after. So you definitely want to carve down some time. It is 30 questions. Okay, so thinking of where you can find a quiet space to make sure that you do your best. It is a unit assessment, excuse me. Okay, so it's more than weighted in the grade book than just simply quizzes. Okay, you're also going to find that the second half of the exam, which is the FRQ, which stands for free response questions. Okay, the free response questions are two essay questions. Okay, so the essay questions are posed. There are two different prompts. Expectation is you're writing an essay response, which is a well thought out, crafted response that's going to use evidence from the text, from the readings, from the flip lectures to demonstrate your knowledge and making sure you're addressing the prompts of the question. All right. Last but not least, again, you'll see the last one that I have open is 6.6, which is going to be the test corrections, as well as a Flipgrid reflection for Unit 1. Okay, and I'll open that up later in the week. You'll have that Flipgrid open to reflect at the end of the week. Okay, right here, just a reminder at the bottom, you can see our team meeting is scheduled, okay, this week, which is Tuesday. If you're not able to attend that, I'm also be posted a Flipgrid makeup. If you have been attending the weekly conference, you should see your points in the gradebook. I also just went through this week and responded to anybody that had a makeup assignment for Flipgrid. So remember, the Flipgrid is great because it's a way for us to talk versus type. So if you have posted videos on the Flipgrid, please make sure you go back and check those because I try to respond to each and every one that is provided. All right. So that being said, I just want to say thank you again for those people that are on top of their assignments. Remember, your progress reports will cover up to week 5. So I'm almost wrapping up, which is week 4 should be entered. And then week 5 reminder is closing tonight. So please, please, please be on top of your assignments. If there's any assistance I can provide, remember, you can always email me through Schoology. That's a great access. But remember, also take advantage of each other in terms of there is the help discussion board. If I'm not responding, obviously I will respond as quickly as I can. But if you're really eager to address a question, help each other out there on the discussion board.